find the value of the loop currents, their first derivatives and second derivatives, all evaluated at t equal to 0 plus. Given that Vc of 0 minus is equal to 1 volt, I2 of 0 minus is equal to 0 amps. At t equal to 0, switch 1 and switch 2 are closed. So this is the given circuit. The circuit consists of two switches. This is switch 1 and this is switch 2. And both the switches will close at t equal to 0. We suppose to calculate the value of the loop currents. Here we have two loops. If we assume the current through this loop is I1 and current through this loop is I2, that is, we'll assume current through this one is I1 and current through this loop is I2, then we suppose to calculate I1 of 0 plus I2 of 0 plus, that is loop currents, their first derivative, that is di1 of 0 plus by dt and di2 of 0 plus by dt, and second derivatives, that is d square I1 of 0 plus by dt square and d square I2 of 0 plus by dt square at t equal to 0 plus. Given that Vc of 0 minus, that is Vc of 0 minus means initial voltage in the capacitor is 1 volt. Initial voltage means voltage before closing the switch, that is Vc of 0 minus is equal to 0 volt, and we know that Vc of 0 minus is equal to Vc of 0 plus, which is also equal to 1 volt. Similarly, it is given that I2 of 0 minus, that is current through inductor before closing the switch, was 0. Therefore, I can say I2 of 0 minus is also equal to I2 of 0 plus, that is current through inductor before closing the switch is same as current through inductor immediately after closing the switch, that is I2 of 0 plus is also equal to 0. Now let's try to calculate I1 of 0 plus and I2 of 0 plus. Now we'll assume that at t equal to 0, the switch will close. We'll write the KVL equation for both the loops, assuming that the switch is closed at t equal to 0 and all the elements in the circuit are present. I'll apply KVL to loop I1. Assume switch SW1 and SW2 are closed at t equal to 0. We'll apply KVL to first loop, that is loop I1. Apply KVL to loop I1. We can write the KVL equation as 10 is equal to voltage drop across 2 ohm resistor is 1 over C integration of I1 into dt plus current through 1 ohm resistor is both I1 and I2. I can write it as 1 I1 minus I2. So here I1 is nothing but I1 of t, I2 is nothing but I2 of t. It is understood, by default it will be function of time. So we'll call it as equation number 1. Now apply KVL to loop 2. Apply KVL to loop 2. Loop I2. So I can write it as 5 sine 2t is equal to drop across 1 ohm resistor, that is 1 I2 minus I1 plus voltage drop across inductor is L di2 by dt. We will call it as equation number 2. So these are the two equations that we got by applying KVL to loop I1 and loop I2. So now at t equal to 0 plus equation 1 can be written as, that is 10 is equal to, so 1 over c integration of I1 dot dt is nothing but Vc of 0 plus, because it is voltage across capacitor. This is Vc of 0 plus, plus we have 1, that is I1 of 0 plus minus I2 of 0 plus. So we can simplify this as 10 is equal to Vc of 0 plus is nothing but Vc of 0 minus, that is 1 volt, plus I1 of 0 plus, keep it as it is because we supposed to calculate I1 of 0 plus, and we know that I2 of 0 plus is nothing but I2 of 0 minus, which is 0. So it is 0. So with this we can find I1 of 0 plus is equal to 10 minus 1, which is equal to 9 amps. So this is the first two parameters, that is I1 of 0 plus is 9 amp and I2 of 0 plus is 0 amp. We can also solve I1 of 0 plus in other way as, at t equal to 0 plus, we know that capacitor acts like short circuit if initial voltage in the capacitor is 0, but here the initial value of the capacitor is 1 volt, so this capacitor acts like voltage source, whereas inductor acts like current, inductor acts like open circuit, so no current flows in this loop. So there exists only one loop. I can draw the circuit here. So switch is closed. Now capacitor acts like voltage source. The magnitude of voltage source is 1 volt and there is 1 ohm resistor. And we know that this, here it is open circuit. Therefore no current flows here. The entire current flows in the circuit is I1 of 0 plus. So from this circuit also we can find I1 of 0 plus as I1 of 0 plus equal to 10 is equal to 1 plus I1 of 0 plus, that is I1 of 0 plus is equal to 9 amps. So this is another way of calculating I1 of 0 plus. And 2 can be written as 5 sine 2t is equal to I2 minus I1 plus L di2 by dt. This was equation number 2. So at t equal to 0 plus, this equation can be written as, so here t value is 0, that is sine 0 is 0, so this side it is 0, is equal to I2 of 0 plus minus I1 of 0 plus plus L d I2 of 0 plus by dt. Simplifying this, 0 equal to I2 of 0 plus is already we calculated, that is 0, minus I1 of 0 plus is 9, plus L value is given, that is 1, d I2 of 0 plus by dt. Therefore d I2 of 0 plus by dt is equal to 9 ampere per second. This is the another required data, that is first derivative of current I2. Now we'll try to calculate first derivative of current I1. differentiate equation 1, we get 0 is equal to, there is 1 over c integration of I1, integration differentiation will get cancel, we will get I1 by c plus di1 by dt minus di2 by dt. So now at t equal to 0 plus, I can write it as at t equal to 0 plus, the same equation can be written as 0 equal to I1 of 0 plus by c plus di1 of 0 plus by dt minus di2 of 0 plus by dt. Simplifying this, I1 of 0 plus value is 9 divided by c, the c value given is 2, plus we need to calculate di1 of 0 plus by dt, keep it as it is, minus di2 of 0 plus is 9. Therefore, we can say di1 of 0 plus by dt is equal to 9 by 2 is 4.5. So 9 minus 4.5, which is 4.5 amperes per second. So this is another required data, that is first derivative of current I1. So now again we'll rewrite equation 2 for reference, that is 5 sin 2t is equal to I2 minus I1 plus L di2 by dt. This was equation 2. Now I need to calculate d square I2 by dt. So if we differentiate this equation, we'll get the term d square I2 by dt, that is second derivative of I2. I'll differentiate this equation, that is differentiation of sin 2t is cos 2t into 2, that is 5 into 2 cos 2t is equal to differentiation of I2 is di2 by dt minus di1 by dt plus L d square I2 by dt square. So here t equal to 0. So when t equal to 0, cos 0 is 1, 5 into 2 is 10, which is equal to, now at t equal to 0 plus, this can be written as di2 of 0 plus by dt minus di1 of 0 plus by dt plus L d square I2 of 0 plus by dt square. We will substitute the values. Di2 of 0 plus is already calculated, that is 9, minus di1 of 0 plus is 4.5 plus the given L value is 1 Henry into d square I2 of 0 plus by dt square. We'll simplify this. Therefore, we can write d square I2 of 0 plus by dt square is equal to 9 minus 4.5 is 4.5, 10 minus 4.5 gives 5.5 amperes per second square. So this is the another required data, that is second derivative of current I2. Now let's calculate. So already we have calculated the first derivative of equation 1. We got the result as 0 equal to I1 by C plus di1 by dt minus di2 by dt. So we'll consider this equation. I'll call it as equation number 3. Now I'll consider the same equation, that is 0 equal to I1 by C plus di1 by dt minus di2 by dt. This was equation 3. Now we'll differentiate this equation, because already in this equation we have first derivative of I1. If you differentiate this, we'll get second derivative of I1. So differentiate equation 3. So I can write it as 0 equal to d I1 of t by dt into 1 over c plus d square I1 of t by dt square minus d square I2 of t by dt square. So now at t equal to 0 plus, this equation can be written as 0 equal to d I1 of 0 plus by dt into 1 over c plus d square I1 of 0 plus by dt square minus d square I2 of 0 plus by dt square. We substitute the values. 0 equal to d I1 of 0 plus is already calculated, that is 4.5 into 1 over c. The value of c is 2, that is 1 by 2, plus we need to calculate d square I1 of 0 plus by dt square minus d square I2, that is 5.5. Simplifying this, we'll get d square I1 of 0 plus by dt square equal to 4.5 divided by 2 minus 5.5. That if we take it on left hand side, we'll get 3.25 ampere by second square. So this is the another required data, that is d square I1 of 0 plus by dt square. Thus we calculated all the parameters required for this circuit, which is having two switches. Thank you for watching.